ज्ञानंजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो महाबदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदाले कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो भक्त्या विहीनाय अपराधलक्ष्यै क्षिप्त्वास्य कामादितरंगमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणं यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मेतया तर्वोभिने तं सर्वभूतहृदयं तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञान राधे त्वं नय मां च My obeisances, humble obeisances, in the lotus feet of my spiritual Gurudev Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kishore Goswami Maharaj, and same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Sri Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. Today, very auspicious day, I told in morning, the disappearance day of Srila Gadadhar Pandit and also of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. We glorified him in morning to some extent. I told Sri Pad Madhava Maharaj, Aranya Maharaj and Ban Maharaj and also to Shyam Rani to discuss about both in their classes. I know, have you discussed all these things today? You know? Oh, today you are sick. Now okay, somewhat? Have you discussed these points? Not so much. I know. You? About Gadadhar Pandit, I told something. And Bhakti Vinod Thakur, that he also told something. That his incarnation of Srila Gadadhar, that is Srimati Radhika, she is Kamal Manjari. He also took birth in Navadvip, Mayapur, and he was friend of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from boyhood. They were studying in the same school of Ganga Das Pandit, Nabhyan Nyaya and Vyakaran, and with them playing with all his associates like Swarup Damodar had his name was at Purushottam, Jagadananda, Murari Gupta, Mukunda, and so many. And went to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, took sannyas, and then he went to Jagannath Puri. So Bhakti Vinod Thakur is none different from Gadadhar Pandit. गौर शक्ति स्वरूपाय रूपानुगा बराय एंड ही इज रूपानुगा इन द रियल सेंस ही प्रीच्ड द सेम मिशन ऑफ श्रील भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर आफ्टर शिप्स गोस्वामी एंड दैट इज व्हाई ही इज कॉल्ड सप्तम गोस्वामी भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर ऑल्सो ही टूक बर्थ इन नवदीप एरिया वेरी नियर टू मायापुर उला कृष्णनगर उला एंड फ्रॉम बॉयहुड इट वॉज वेरी इंटेलिजेंट स्पीकिंग इंग्लिश एंड राइटिंग एसेज इन इंग्लिश एंड दस ही वॉज वेरी वेरी फेमस इन होल बेंगाल ही ऑल्सो वेंट टू पुरी एंड ही वॉज इलेक्टेड लाइक मजिस्ट्रेट एंड कमांडर इन चीफ लाइक दिस फॉर जगन्नाथ टेम्पल सुपरिंटेंडेंट ऑफ दैट मैनेजिंग एवरीथिंग एंड ही वॉज सो वेरी बोल्ड वंस अपॉन ए टाइम ओ देयर इज अ वेरी फेमस मैजिशियन And he told that I am Krishna myself. I'm so powerful that I can make a rash with the young ladies of whole Odisha. And he been invited. And they were so much inspired. All the ladies, beautiful ladies of whole Odisha state, they came. Their husband became so much upset. And they filed a case against him and government deputed him to see this case. The day on full moon, that yogi wanted to make a rash with all the ladies of Odisha, young ladies, 10 years old. All were so much inspired. Bhakti Vinod Thakur at that time, he went there. And he requested that yogi not to do. It will upset whole state. He told that I am God, myself, Krishna. In a moment I can destroy whole world and I can create. I am so powerful. Bhakti Vinod Thakur told that you cannot make a leg of even ant. I know. You are not powerful. Don't be in false ego. You should not make rash and don't make anything against government. He told that I am against government, I will destroy all government and then I will control myself, whole India, whole world. Oh, you are so powerful. He told that if you are not obeying me, my order of the government, I will arrest you. He told that, how you can arrest? I will, in a moment I can destroy you. Fire will come for my this. And you will be burned to ashes. Then Bhakti Vinod Thakur told that, I must arrest you. You are going to do against Bhagavatam and everything. You are not God. I know you. You are a lusty person. Knowing something, you can do. Then he told that, you should go. He ordered the police. And you should cut his ears off. But when they used to go to him and he was doing and fire were coming, so much fires. So they were feared. Even district magistrate and all were upset. What to do? Then Bhakti Vinay took what? And caught hold of that yogi and he sapped him. I will see you. I will punish you. You should punish. I will see. And then he was arrested and taken to Cuttack. And there, in court, there was a case and he was brought there. Bhakti Vinod Thakur told that, I am requesting again that you give up all these things and be a simple person. Otherwise, they will punish you. Oh, you will see in morning, next morning. And he did some miracle. And Bhakti Vinod Thakur became ill, sick, something very painful in his stomach. And he became sick so much degrees of fever. Bhakti Vinod Thakur was chanting Hare Krishna, nothing to fear. And he came to court and he ordered that he should go to jail if he is not obeying our request. And then he tried so much, but he could not do anything. So my request to devotees, be very strong if you are chanting Hari name. If you are chanting Hari name, no ghost, no bad mantra, no bad elements can attack you. So you should give up your all kinds of fears. Any demon cannot come. Any bad element cannot come. No, any ghost or anything, even goddess can come and attack you. If you are doing so, then it means that you are so weak. You have no faith on your mantra. Only Nrisingh Namaj is sufficient for them. You are chanting, Om Nrisingadev, Om Nrisingaya Namah, Nrisingaya Namah. All ghosts, all kinds of bad elements will go. So I advise the devotees that those should not think that any ghost is coming. Any powerful mantra is coming to me, they cannot come. They may come for a moment, but when you will chant Hare Krishna, more powerful than Nrisingh mantra, even anyone cannot come. So you should be very strong and without any fear, nirbhay, you should be. And chant Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare. All kinds of problems will go away. So you should be strong like Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Don't fear from anyone, but don't be what? Aggressive. Don't be aggressive. You should be very humble and polite. And thus chanting Hare Nam, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Then he was a very good manager also. Sometimes an offer of 1 lakh rupee, 2 lakh rupee, 5 lakh rupee came to him. We will bribe you, 5 lakh rupee. You should keep a dog, a statue on the temple. Mayavadi were telling that God and dog are same. So you should put. Oh, he refused. He never took that bribe. Dog is not God. But they tell that everything is God. But this idea is bogus idea. Dog is not God. But in dog also Krishna is there. Like Sakshi, no harm. But both are not same. Oh, he wrote Jaiva Dharma, very valuable book, comprehensive book from Vedas, Upanishad, oh, Puran, Srimad, essence of Bhagavad, Chaitanya, Charitamrita, everything. If you are reading Jaiva Dharma, it means that you are reading Bhagavad, Chaitanya, Charitamrita, oh, Ved, Upanishad, everything you have read. I have not read anything, not so much Upanishad and Vedas, Puran, Srimad Bhagavat or Chaitanya Charitamrita. But I, by the mercy of my Gurudev, I read about 100 times Jaiva Dharma. And new things coming. Each time I translated it. For this I went to so many senior Vaishnavas, like Sauti Maharaj, Guru Maharaj and all others. Ban Maharaj at that time. Oh, Puri Maharaj. Giri Maharaj. You don't know them. I was very fortunate. to be in their association of all the elevated disciples of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada. I was so lucky. I have their mercies. They have bestowed their mercies to me. So, Jaiva Dharma is a very comprehensive book from A to Z. Everything is there. If you are reading and practicing, very easily you can enter in the realm of pure bhakti. Very soon. Even how to enter in Radha Krishna conjugal love, have an affection, and how you can be qualified to go enter in the realm of Radha Kunda and Shyam Kunda and their kunjas. Oh, you can know all the everything. So Bhakti Vinod Thakur is so merciful to us. Gadadhar Pandit came in the shape of Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Kamal Manjari came in the shape of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. You should read Jaiva Dharma. We have printed first chapter, first canto, part. Oh, very soon two parts will come. So you should wait for second and third, but you should begin one time, two time, three time, and you'll realize so much things. Now, today I want to discuss on the subject of Bhagavatam 10th canto. Some confusion came. A preacher from India came and something he told that we don't like. And nowhere it is written like what he told. So you should, I think that wash that your doubts about this and be clear, especially for those who are sincere and senior, those who know something, they have come and they are entering in Madhyamadhika. So you should know all these things clearly. There should be no doubt in. Anyone may say that we should not read 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam. I will not listen there, this warning. I will tell that I produce any evidence that we should not. Oh, whether in Srimad Bhagavatam it has been written, in Chaitanya Charitamrita written, or any guru in our line has written like this. Even your Gurudev has told like this. He cannot answer. Never. I know that Swamiji never written like this. Can you produce that thing? Some portion. You should read and stand up. Stand up. Can you stand up? You can put your dand here. No. What Swamiji has written, it is clear from his writings. You should hear this. Don't sleep. Don't neglect.
Someone was writing to Srila Prabhupada about whether or not the devotees could hear and chant about the gopis. Srila Prabhupada replied, the policy
you
should
have
be
that, book?
That the people may not understand the gopis
he can
like
read.
Ordinary girls.
Give him.
You should be careful to present the gopis. It does not mean that we shall not utter even the name of the gopis. We have taken a vow to boycott the gopis. No, they are our worshipful devotees. How can we avoid them? This is a letter now to Hayagriva Prabhu in 1968. Srila Prabhupada wrote, the deity worship must be continued by everyone.
Another, what he is telling? Everyone means? What is the meaning of everyone? Only elevated, Mahabhagavat liberated person? Everyone? From top to bottom. Those who are also new foil. Even for them he is telling, everyone, sure.
Another secret of success is that when one is very much sexually disturbed,
yes,
he should think of Krishna's pastimes with the gopis and he will forget his sex urge.
What meaning? Swamiji was, your Prabhupada was so ignorant, how he could write? But he has written. He was authentic person. No wrong, nothing. And it is for everyone. Go on.
One should think of Krishna's pastimes with the gopis, but not try to imitate them.
Oh, don't do imitation. Never. You should hear his pastimes with honor. Then your lust will go. Especially for Ras Leela is powerful among all the pastimes of Krishna. Ras Leela is medicine. And it has been told like that, what? Nivritta tarshai rupagiyamanat baushadhatra shotri bhimano bhirama kahuttam shloka gunanubadat virajyet. What is the meaning? Those who are not hearing this Ras Leela or the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam, they are pasugna. What is the meaning of pasugna? Self-killer.
Like
killing others and also him, if they are not hearing. Nivritta tarsai upagiyamanat. What is the meaning?
Nivritta tarsai upagiyamanat means that those persons who are nivritta tarsai, they have no thirst for material enjoyment, liberated souls. They speak the pastimes of Krishna. And their speaking of these pastimes is Vabhaushadi. It is the cure for the contamination of material existence. It is like a medicine. So ka uttama shloka gunana vardat. What kind of person will not listen to the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam? Only a very cruel person who would like to kill themselves and also kill others.
So here it has been told, those who are bhakta, those who are full of lust, those who are liberated, those who are bhakta,